Hey everybody, it's 8-Bit Blaze here with Ryan and Sarah. Today we'll be playing some more Megadimension Neptunia.
Yeah, whee! I was about to say, there's nothing stopping me.
Hey, actual voices.
Alright, I think we're in the clear. Okay, Gearsy, seriously, what the hell was that?
Well, you were in danger, Uzume. My body just kind of moved on its own. And before I knew it, I was jumping out of the turf.
None of that matters. I shouldn't even have been part of that equation. This was your chance. What are you doing wasting it on me? So stupid.
It wasn't stupid. And it wasn't a waste. You're still here and you're safe. And that's what matters to me, okay? If I have to sacrifice someone to get home, then it's not worth it to me. I'm sure Big Sis would say the exact same thing.
But then, how can I ever forgive myself for ruining your only way home?
Uzume, it's in the past. What's important now is to begin planning our next move.
That's easy. We're going right back over there and wrecking each and every last one of them. Maybe Gearsy can still make it back home.
Even if we return there, if the terminal was heavily beaten in the battle, I doubt it's usable any longer.
Then what are we supposed to do?
Our current foe differs from the giant in that she has clear objectives when mounting her attack. I propose we evacuate this area completely.
You really want us to run away from her?
Not exactly. We'll need to devise an appropriate strategy of retaliation, considering this foe is so different from what we've faced in the past. Concurrently, we can also be considering alternative options to return Gearsy home.
Okay, as long as we get to fight back. I hate being passive. It doesn't feel right.
Understood. Let us return to our main base. Some of our friends may be able to offer help.
Sorry to interrupt, but what do you mean by main base, Uzume? Wasn't this your base?
I guess I never mentioned it. This was just a temporary base we created for our bouts with the giant. And don't think asking me questions is gonna make me forget your foolish move. You're in for a long lecture once we get over there, Gearsy.
Please go easy on me.
Alright, we did advance to the actual dungeon.
Yeah.
Here? Okay!
Triangle.
Oh, this cave is your main base? I think I can hear monsters. Nah, this isn't it. What is this, what is this place, Umio?
It's a shortcut I found not too long ago. We run less of a risk of being spotted traveling through here than walking outside. There are monsters inside, but, well, I'm sure you two can handle it.
Well, that was a very shortcut. Oh. Well, well, well. I wondered where they were heading, but it looks as if these rats are voluntarily heading into our trap.
Don't let the accent jack up your words.
Then, as you fools so desire, I will kill you slowly and painfully. Muhahaha. She doesn't really laugh.
Well, first of all, she said ha-ha, not mwaha.
Well, ha-ha just sounds better.
You just screw off, just move.
Wait, can I actually change it to where I'm walking around?
As other characters, yes. You just have to set them to your leader. It's like you could walk around as Uzume if you wanted to. Does it really matter right now?
No,
just go over and hit X on whatever character you want to walk around.
Yeah. That's all it is. Oh, dear.
You got snuck up on.
Did you do something?
Well, it's not like I meant
it's to. My turn!
Okay.
Then Uzume actually takes damage. Nebgear missed a hit.
Yeah! Your die! These are a lot stronger than.
Yeah.
Don't mess with me! You are what such did a
I
do?
I didn't think these were gonna be stronger. Well, they're dead now, so it doesn't matter.
The bad part is, Nebgear's got a weapon on that increases her hit rate, and she's still missing an attack.
That's yeah! Funny. Level up!
Yeah! I like using myself in.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know why I was forgetting how to do controls.
Yeah.
Do controls.
What's
this? Yes. I was forgetting how to control.
No.
No, don't jump down. Okay. That's where you started.
Bunny.
Hey, Gearsy, I'm a little late in asking, but you didn't forget to bring your in-gear, did you? I have it right here. It's my most important possession next to my life, so I made sure to bring it. Huh? What's wrong? It won't turn on. It might be because I yanked out the cable pretty hard while escaping. Did it get broken? Maybe I could give it a whack for ya. Whack it? You want to hit my in-gear?
The in-gear.
The in-gear. You know, it's like when you whack a TV and it gets fixed, right? I hit my radio too and it acts up. Although, since it's getting old, even if I whack it, it doesn't help. I think that hitting it is just making the damage even worse. What? Really? I think so, since I have the chance, I can fix it once we get to the base. I have to figure out why the end gear isn't working also. Could you maybe modify my visual radio to be all cool like yours? You could add some awesome functions to it. Oh, that's a good idea. Is there any function you would like me to add? Now that you ask, I can't think of nothing. Well, we have some time. Give it some thought before we reach your base. Will do.
I thought the two would be depressed, but it looks as if I was needlessly worried.
I just stopped that just for that.
Item, you walked right past it.
What's this?
Turn around before you start walking, because he's trapped you in. Okay, you walked away.
Ha ha ha. There's no item, right?
No. If you use that, you're gonna go back to the entrance.
Like a bunny!
Like a bunny. Nepgear says like a bunny, and Neptune says like a kangaroo.
I found an what? So
yeah, I can't do anything
about
that.
You got attacked from the back, yeah.
It's confirmed.
Ah!
My turn.
You could have hit both.
Oh. Well, now they both get to hit things.
You're in the way!
There we go.
You charge the EXE gauge for no reason.
Does it matter if I do or not?
No, because you lose it after every battle.
Yeah, but I mean, what I mean is that, does it really matter?
Well, no, but... Which I still think is stupid. You can't build it up and then try to go into a boss fight. Granted, that would be a little OP, because you just use specials right off the bat later on.
Do I go up or down?
Down. You came from that way.
Mm-hmm. No, Digimon!
There's no way you ran it around that.
Digimon!
The bad thing is they can hurt you.
Why am I stuck on the Digimon thing?
I don't know, you need to drop it. No, it's not. Nepier's still
missing. Okay, it's every time I do the rush thing, that's when I hit, or do the other attacks, that's when I hit more.
It's because rush has more attacks, but they do less damage than power ones.
Alright, defeated.
Nepier can't get hurt.
That's for hurting me, or hitting me.
Which, if Nepgear can't get hurt, that's going to make this boss fight really awkward.
Well, let's go for it anyway. I'm not fighting you right now.
Like, nah.
I'm going for it.
No, hold on. Item.
Oh. For some reason, I was thinking it was in the other...
Item. Bridge.
Found an item.
Am I good now?
Yes.
Okay.
Aren't we there yet, Umeo?
Triangle.
This is most strange. It should have been straight along this path. Don't be alarmed, but it appears that we've lost our way. Let us retrace our steps.
Playtime is over, brats.
Oh, you're that pop-up purple hag!
I am not a pop-up purple hag! My name is R4. A name that will signal your demise and ring the bell of destruction for this hopeless world.
This location does not exist on any map in existence. How do you know of this place?
Simple. I took the liberty of following you fools who didn't have the sense to cover your tracks. Because of your stupidity, I was able to trap you all here in this dead end, so thank you.
Whoa, like, gross! Being a stalker is, like, so totally creepy! Ew! Wizume, your speech!
Blast. My deepest apologies to you both. I should have known better. This is my fault.
Oh, you don't gotta be sorry, Umeo. We'll just have to crush her. No sweat.
Yeah, Uzume's right. We might be cornered, but we don't have a super huge horde of monsters to fight here. We can do it!
A cornered animal has nothing to lose. We'll get in her face and rip her stupid grin to shreds. You won't even recognize her when we're done.
You too.
R4, prepare yourself. Your life will end here.
What? What did you say just now?
Huh? I said... R4, prepare yourself. Your life will end here.
Just the first part. Just say the first part one more time.
The first... You mean, just say your name? R4?
One more time, with some respect.
Miss R4?
Oh. Since first I appeared, it's been Arsnor this, Arbor that, or pop-up purple hag, the worst. Finally, finally, you called me by my name!
Ah, I guess she was actually pretty bothered by her name calling. Hey, R4, since I called you by name, you'll let us pass by you now,
right? The chair squeaking is going to stay.
Of course. You are one of the few... No, the only one who's ever used my name. That is an effortless request to fulfill.
Yay! Thank you so much!
Idiot. You really expected me to do that?
Aw, darn. I knew it.
Show's over. We'll just make our way by force. Looks like you're alone, too. We're gonna make you regret not bringing reinforcements. Gearsy, let's get serious.
You got it.
Will you stop prancing around like the weaklings I know that you are? I alone am enough for you, twerps. Prepare to die.
I won't hold back!
The time of the apocalypse is now.
I guess we have to do this.
No.
What?
You're supposed to lose this fight.
What if you win?
The same thing occurs, but...
I'm so tired.
I'm gonna win this thing.
I just hope she doesn't heal faster than you can actually hurt her. Or this is gonna be a never-ending fight.
Oh, I get to attack again? That's weird.
Well, it's all based on your... Look at the active time battle gauge in the top right. That's who goes next.
Okay.
I won't go easy.
Okay, it looks like she's probably not gonna be able to hurt either one of you.
No,
so. Nope. Uzume gets hurt.
Just use your skill.
I'll go full power! There!
You're not doing any damage, really. I think I missed. I missed both times.
I'll go calmly. Please prepare yourself!
Yeah, like I said, you're supposed to lose this fight.
Well, we're gonna win this fight, apparently.
Wow.
Cause, I can't get hurt, apparently.
Well, normally in New Game Plus, you can win anyway, cause if you carry over your levels and everything.
But since I have that ultimate weapon and then the extra...
I guess you're clearing challenges, I guess.
Okay, so... Like, she's the only one that's not doing anything, really.
I won't hold back!
And I'm like, here I am, just going... I just do the rush because I don't want... I hate missing. Like, I hate it. Let's do this one.
Not bad.
I no longer have doubts.
Wow, am I almost done?
By the way, just saying, right now it probably doesn't matter, but your two characters are awfully close if she can hit both of them.
Okay.
So I would keep that in mind. I know.
Yeah, I know. I forget about it.
I know she can't hurt Nep Gear, but that's going to run into a problem when the enemies start actually being able to
I won.
Yeah, that's going to be a problem once enemies actually can start hurting you.
Oh, OP.
And you bunch your characters up.
I probably shouldn't have played with all your extra stats and stuff because I'm very OP in this.
Well, you gain 2 levels. But no,
Do you want to just go to the scene or just...
Go to the scene. Why would we not?
Okay. I was wondering, you were just talking, so I didn't want to...
Well, no, I'm saying some of the parts were ridiculously hard, and, like, one of the bosses in the second game is ridiculous.
You're way too strong for a lowly pop-up hag, but it's not enough. We nabbed this victory.
Oh, maybe that's the wrong battle you're supposed to lose.
What delusions are you living in? I've barely used half of my strength.
Okay, so that one you were supposed to win.
Uzume won't fall for that.
Your ignorance will...
This is the one you're supposed to lose.
Stop talking!
You to learn your place the hard way. My true form and my true power!
That form! Why are you in that form? Ew! Gross! Gearsy, I don't think I want to fight her anymore! It'll be so gross to touch her! What? Did you really just say that? Kidding, I'm kidding! Oh, you're so cute when you're in a panic, Gearsy. Goodness. Joking around at a time like this is bad for my poor heart.
Oh, you girls think this is a time for jokes? Very well then, suit yourself. Die!
Why is the it's delayed on her speech? Why?
This can't be.
I can't muster any strength.
What's that? No witty joke. No punchline at my expense.
That thing's ugly.
Go ahead. Call me a pop-up hag again. I dare you.
That's just two of her.
This is it, Kiersey. I'm sorry.
Yes. Wait, that voice.
What is that? What is it, Kiersey?
I thought I just heard Neptune's voice.
Nepsy's voice?
Don't think I'll fall for such an obvious time-wasting bluff. I will end you!
Move, move, move! I'm gonna crash!
Huh?
So much smoke!
What? What fell? Were those losers really able to call for reinforcements?
Oh, man. I really took a tumble there. Shoot, I was so close to finally catching a skyfish. I didn't realize the ground was missing there. It's a good thing the body is resilient enough to keep working, even after taking a fall from such tall heights.
What?
Oh, it's the people who were down below. Hey, you guys hurt? Everyone okay?
Who are you?
Me? My name's Neptune.
Yay!
To be honest, I'm a bug hunter who explores other dimensions. I just happen to be passing by. Whoops. Looks like you all were in the middle of something. Sorry for interrupting you. I think I get what's going on here. Considering I'm an ally to all cute girls, I'm gonna be helping you with your situation here. Hey, cutie, with the pink hair, what's your name?
Me?
Yep, you.
My name is Nepgear.
Wow, you have Nep in your name too! Crazy! This Nep can't help but feel like there is some kind of sentimental fate at play here.
Hey.
Hey, hey, Umio! What's going on? Nepsy left, grew up super fast, and then fell on us!
Even I cannot begin to understand this. But if she's willing to help us, her presence will be quite appreciated.
Hey!
She's getting
it's delaying, like, on hers.
Are you guys Nepgear's friends? That thing on your wrist is really cool. Let me see it.
Cool? If you can understand the level of cool my radio wields, then even in your adult state, you're pretty smart, Nepsy!
Hey!
Nepsy, now is not the time for...
Wait, what's this fish? That's hilarious! Look at his serious mug!
I said, hey!
I want to say almost after her speech started hitting
X. Yikes, the weirdo lady just lost it.
Cease your pointless babbling! How dare you cretins ignore me!
Oh, sorry. Did you want us to include you in our conversation? Because... no. I think I'll pass on including a terrible person who torments cute girls. Plus, no offense, but you look kind of creepy.
Running your mouth like that? I, R4, will have you pay for making a mockery of me! You will pay with your life.
Arbor? What a weird name!
It's not R4, it's R4! R4!
Arfjord? Why do they call you that? I seriously doubt anyone sailed up that inlet in over a millennia. I'd blame your wardrobe.
Why you?!
Wow! Nepsy's amazing! No one comes close to her in riling up Grandma Arfie over there!
I think the bigger problem is that R4 is just unable to cope with being instigated.
Only you.
I will never forgive you. I'll murder all four of you at once!
Oh, hold up. Quick timeout.
Huh?
It's RPG tradition to heal up before battle. Today, as a special present, I'll give you girls the Netball V2 that I just made.
It's a totally crazy color, but is it all right?
They say bitter medicine's the best, so a little bitterness is kind of fun. Go ahead, slam it down like milk after a nice hot bath. All in one go. Do it!
Okay. Ugh, it's really bitter. But, wow, my wounds are healing.
I think my strength's coming back too. We can probably win against her now.
Now, let's get pumped up for the boss battle.
Oh my goodness, I love it.
Dang it, you get no equipment change. I auto-Neptunes, dang it.
I shall go forth. Just kidding.
I'm okay with this.
I'm more concerned about our weapons, but...
Useless! I guess we have to do this! Here I come! It's Uzume's turn!
She's like gonna miss everything, because...
I shall go!
Okay, is this the one I'm supposed to lose?
I swear it was the last one, but apparently I was wrong.
This thing is even creepier, like, because you can't see the mouth with the dialogue. Look at that thing! Oh, I see her. There she is, and then... Oh, okay.
Yeah, this is Deity of Sin R4.
I probably should move my characters.
She does have a special that can hit every, like, three characters at once. So.
This one?
Sure.
Raging Rush!
Her office. And she's wearing shoes with it, too, so it's really funny looking.
Ta-da!
I didn't think I was going to put her in a bathing suit.
It auto does the equipment by the stats.
I no longer have doubts.
So the bathing suit must have better stats than her default equipment.
That's hilarious.
Please prepare yourself!
Ruin to all!
Ow! You punched me.
What stats does that fallen Neptune item on her head have?
I don't know, but apparently that's what... I think it's Neptune. Is it Neptune?
It's Neptune. That's a gag they keep with every other game is Neptune falling out of the sky.
Oh, right. What's funny is
in the very first game, she does that. And Victory 1, she does that. The only game Neptune doesn't fall out of the sky in is the Mark 2.
Yeah.
I won.
It's a victory for hope, dreams, and the latest technology. I feel power overflowing. One of my dreams came true!
Level up! V for victory!
Impossible. How could I be defeated by these foolish children?
Bam.
Believe it. You're done. Huh? Hey, are you two CPUs, perchance?
Definitely. Sorry for the late intro, but I'm Uzume, and I'm the CPU of this nation. Thanks a lot for the help. We really needed it.
Ooh, even in your normal form, you're pretty cool looking.
You think I'm cool looking? Ha! I knew you'd get my vibe, Nepsy!
You know, in your normal state, Nepgear, your looks are pretty similar to mine. If I ever had a younger sister, she might even look like you. Aw, what a pretty thought. I'd love to have a younger sister someday.
Awkward. Now, Nepsy. You're troubling Gearsy.
Oops. Sorry, Gearsy. I didn't mean to trouble you. I just got excited. Oh, that's right. What do we do with this grotesque lady? Arbor, was it?
What should we do? I didn't really think of what to do with her after she'd been defeated.
We hadn't really expected the tables to turn in our favor like that. But now we have the perfect opportunity to beat some sense into her. Now then, what to do? I'm gonna punish you in my own super stylish way, so I hope you're prepared.
I no longer have any will to fight you. Aren't you a CPU? As a CPU, you should treat prisoners according to the law.
Law? Like I give a crap. I'm the CPU of this nation, and that means I am the law. Whatever I do is the frickin' law. Even if I beat you to a bloody dead pulp, as long as it's cool in my book, that's all that matters, right? Huh? Answer me!
Violence is not the answer!
Usume's really getting into it, huh?
She's acting like a nasty delinquent. This isn't unexpected. There has been a startling amount of rage welling inside of her.
She's turning into quite the villain.
Hey, hold your horses! Violence is no good!
What? You're going to save me?
Step aside, Big Nepsy. I have no obligation to this monster, and she's not getting out alive.
It's a bad move, Uzume. Anyway, I've decided to put this gross bug into my specimen book, so you can't.
What?
I mean, come on! Check out those purple wings! She's like some kind of poisonous butterfly, so she's gotta be a rare creature. So, I'm gonna put her into my specimen book alive and make her part of my collection.
Well, she is the most vile creature here.
Exactly! Well, that's the deal, so it's absorption time! Let's go!
I'm getting sucked in!
Goodness! She's really shrinking and getting absorbed by that crazy book!
Last but not least, I just tape her down and voila! It's finished!
Huh. That's a pretty dope book if it can turn that hulking beast into a stupid little bug.
What is the meaning of this? Who do you fools think I am? Release me this instant!
I think she's saying something. Hey! If the book ends up so thick, won't you be unable to fully close it?
Hey! Don't you dare ignore me!
Oh, no worries about that. There.
Whoa! You squished her!
Oh, no, she's totally fine. I don't really get it, but if I close the book, I can preserve her as is. It's super convenient.
This is so weird, but really freaking awesome.
At the very least, it will reduce the burden of carrying her around. And we can speak to her at our leisure afterwards.
I'd still like to get a few punches in, though.
Sure. But let's keep moving back to the base for now.
Right. You gonna tag along, Big Nepsy?
Is that okay with everyone?
Of course. You saved us, after all. I'd really like to thank you somehow.
Yippee! I've been kind of bummed out since I got here. It's been super lonely without anyone around. Plus, I've run out of food, so I've been on the brink of starvation for a little while.
No,
get fed.
If you're gonna talk, I have to pause this.
Hit triangle real quick.
Thanks so much.
Do you know how she says she was almost starving, ran out of food, and was on the verge of starvation?
Yeah.
In the first Victory Games, since I don't know if we're ever gonna be able to play it since we can't record on PS3. Mm-hmm. Of the Ultra Dimension, there's Plutia as the CPU of the Planetoon.
Yeah.
And by the CPU of Tari, mm-hmm. who's referenced in here, is just for future reference. Her version of herself in Neptune's dimension, Hyper Dimension, sends Neptune to Ultra Dimension, where that whole game's based in, where she meets another version of Noir, Blonde, and Vert, but not the CP candidates.
Okay. What's the point?
Basically, when Nepgear ends up in the Dimension 2, they make a joke, because they... Neptune asks Minnie, we're fine.
Oh my goodness, I don't like just pausing.
Okay, calm your butt. Neptune asks him the mini Histy, which is another version of Histoire, mm-hmm. about if there's another version of her in that dimension. And they all start joking around. It's like, if she didn't end up as a CPU because Plutia became one. And they're like, well, she probably starved because she ran out of pudding and crap like that, and she ended up dying. That's what that reference is.
Okay.
Okay, just hit triangle.
Let us depart then. We may speak at length once we arrive at...
Well, if I just said in Ultra Dimension they made a reference to that, you wouldn't have understood anything of it.
Yes, but you, went to, a roundabout way.
Okay, basically, it's a reference to the first Victory game, which I don't know if we'll get a chance to play.
Yeah. Going here?
So I feel like I just wasted, 5 minutes listening to that.
You poor thing.
One-on-one.
Let's nip things.
You probably should have changed...
I forgot.
In my book.
Just say, make sure you hit the right one.
I can't. I swear it doesn't let me skip this.
I don't think you can.
Yeah! How's that? Was it cool?
I just wouldn't worry about it.
Okay. Let's change.
Too hard.
Oh, that's not what I want to do.
Equipment. Okay, pick that one. I think it's that. Find the one that increases tech. That one.
Ta-da!
I would do that one. Just leave it there. And as for the thing on her head,
does it fit me well?
I would do the where is it? Oh, you don't get it till you pick it up in the game. Never
Ta-da!
Mind.
Well, I'm just gonna do this one because I actually like her normal outfit.
But her health is so low.
I'm just gonna go
here.
Because if I swear, if I got into another fight, I'm just gonna
triangle.
Oh, this is our main base. Wow. So. There are still a few areas where nature appears to have been untouched. This is a very wonderful place.
Is a very wonderful place.
Huh? Miss Uzume's return? It's been a while, you guys. I'm back. Hey, look, everyone. Miss Uzume is back. It's Miss Uzume and Umio. Welcome back, Miss Uzume. You too, Umio. Oh, there are people we don't know. Oh my goodness, a bunch of monsters appeared. This isn't just my base. All these guys have tragically lost their homes, so they live here and look out for each other.
Those whose homes disappeared with the land, those attacked by dangerous monsters, and those whose homes burned because of the giant. They were all rescued by Uzume and brought here.
That's why there are so many monsters living here. You're so amazing, Uzume. You saved so many monsters doing this. It's not a big deal or anything. These guys also look for share crystals for my sake. I really admire them.
Hey, this is a barrel bathtub, isn't it? It's my first time seeing the real deal. I want to soak in it. Even in adulthood, Nepsy still acts the same. This may be sudden, but could you explain to us who you are? You can take a bath afterwards, yes? Yep, that's okay with me. In return, could you tell me about this world and about you guys? I was alone all this time, so I don't understand anything about what's going on. Ooh, so there's another me out there? I'd like to meet her.
So it's correct to say that you're a different Neptune from my Neptune.
That's right. From what I can tell, the world you're from and my world are different, too.
So, that means in your world, there's a CPU ruling a nation that isn't you?
Uh-huh. I think she was a CPU named Plu something. Although I've spent more time traveling through different dimensions than at home, so I've never even met or seen her.
Could it be? Wait a second, did you just say you're traveling through different dimensions?
I like how they just skipped over the whole Plu part.
Yeah.
Yep, why? Something wrong?
Would that mean you can travel at will to any dimension you want?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
That's great, Gearsy. It's so freaking lucky we could find you a ride home so soon. I have a big favor, Neptune. You see, I'm stuck here and I was wondering, could you take me back to my dimension? The route we had discovered for me to get back home before was destroyed by R4.
Of course I'll take you. Although I'm not actually the one who can move through worlds. That's Krosty's thing. Krosty? So where is this person? When we made it to this world, we saw some huge giant. Then she said it looked interesting and flew off after it. We found our next objective.
Yeah, we've defeated that pop-up hag. So starting tomorrow, let's look for Krosty. Okay.
What time are we at?
We're like at 34.
Let's just keep going.
Okay, I'll at least want to do one more conversation, then probably call it good.
Yep, and here comes the next bath scene.
Woo! Woo, what a nice bath. Yeah, looking at the scenery while taking a bath in a barrel is nice. It kind of has its own charm. I think it's even nicer if all three of us weren't squished in here. I guess it was a stretch for all three of us to get in.
No way. Baths are the best when everyone takes them together. That's
the trope.
I'll have to write about this later in my nep note.
Huh? Isn't that your specimen book?
The NEP note is a notebook, you know. It's a convenient notebook that I write in along with being a specimen book. Also, something I put in the book is a special ability. I can draw out a part of that ability and use it freely.
Draw out part of that power and use it freely.
Pout, whatever. I mean,
that's amazing. I can't believe a book like that exists.
Because I've had this notebook, I was able to travel to different dimensions using Krosty's ability. But this is the first time I've taken a bath together with friends like this. Aw, what bliss.
Hey, Gearsy, I just wanted to say I'm sorry. You're still feeling guilty? I'm not bothered by it, so you shouldn't feel responsible, Izume. But because of me, it's okay. It would have been irresponsible of me to leave while some serious problems of yours remained unsolved. As a result, I was still able to find a way back home, so I'm glad. But you still won't come with me, will you? Yeah, it's such a kind offer for you to make, but I can't. I'm sorry. Please don't worry. It's okay. Even if I forced you to come, I just feel too bad knowing you wouldn't be happy. Nepsi asked me if I wanted to come to your world too. She did? Yep, she was worried about the same thing you are, but in the end, I'm a CPU. Someday I'm going to rebuild this nation so that people can live here again. If I build it, they will come. Oh my goodness. Sorry, that's like the funniest thing ever to me.
Why?
It's a movie reference. I'm starting from scratch, and this place is a wasteland, but all I see is a field of dreams. If dreams come true, I can visit you. The movie's called Field of Dreams, and it literally just cracks me up that this is in here.
Her system is Dreamcast. That's why I know. Dream thing.
But there's literally a movie, I think, called Field of Dreams, and they said if we build them, they will come. Oh, and literally, Jesus!
You're telling me getting mad at me for stalling. That's exactly what you just did.
Promise? Promise. I really want that to happen, so I swear. I'll get back to you.
I'll get you back to your world.
Okay. Why are you giggling? I just thought you were being cool. Whoa, really? You finally get how cool I am, huh? Yeah, just like I thought. I knew I was awesome. Oh, but you really are kind of cute, getting so worked up about someone thinking you're cool. Aw, they're so cute. I think we're going to end it here, though.
We've been running episodes at 50 minutes. Just keep going.
Oh my goodness! Could I talk to you for a second? Because Ryan's a butt.
I'm just not going to read it.
Oh my goodness, go!
What's up?
I know this is kind of selfish of me, but would it be okay for me to call you Big Sis?
Oh, so that's what this is about. Sure, Nepgear, that's quite alright with me.
Thank you, Big Sis.
Aw, such a new feeling. Could you call me that one more time?
Okay, Big Sis.
Aw, man, Big Sis sounds so great. Please, just one more time.
Big Sis.
One more.
Big Sis. How long is this gonna go on for?
One more set.
That was random. The power system's broken after all. I can't use it like this. How's it, Gearsy? Can it be fixed? The power system is completely broken, so it looks like repairs are impossible. I see. If only there were a replacement part or something. Oh, that's it. There was that method. Excuse me. Could you let me borrow your visual radio? You're not thinking of taking a part of it, are you?
Part of it.
Of course not. I was going to add some parts from the in-gear to the radio. You did want me to modify it. It's perfect. But is that all right? Isn't that in-gear really important? I have a bunch of them back in my world, so it's perfectly fine. It's finished. Dog barking. It doesn't look any different, though. If it got too big, it would get in the way of your wrist, so I did my best to compress it all inside. It's not 100% like the in-gear, but most of the functions should be usable, and its original functions have been improved. Really? You're amazing, Gearsy. Please take good care of it. You bet. I'll take care of it for life. Okay, well, I guess... Oh, we really crammed like a whole thing in there.
Nep Station. It's your favorite info program, NEP Station, now in Technicolor.
Technicolor.
This is your new and slightly nervous host, Neptune, and...
Uzume...
Tonoboshi.
Thank you for saying that, because you know I wasn't gonna say that properly. Reporting in, hi, Big Nepsy.
Hi, Uzume. So straight to the point, I didn't think I'd show up here so soon after my first appearance.
This show'll get stuck in a rut if it's just me and Nepsy. So we gotta spice it up somehow.
Darn straight.
Still, you really saved our bacon by dropping in on us recently. Thank you. Oh, thanks again.
You don't have to thank me. Thank the Skyfish. They're the real MVPs. I was just hungry.
Hey, are Skyfish yummy? Can you actually eat them?
Great question, Uzume. I don't know, but they're called Skyfish, so they should be edible, right?
Oh my goodness.
I think they're a kind of white fish. You really haven't eaten them, Uzume?
No, I haven't, but they're unidentified mysterious animals, you know. I'm curious.
Was that hard to say, Uzume?
Yeah.
Then I just have to prove they exist by catching and eating it. Bring it on.
For now, let's pull this back together and get to the episode preview.
Go to the episode preview.
I'll leave it to you, Big Nepsy.
The everyday life we believed in without question crumbled away in a single instant. Our familiar landscape wrapped in flames, a daunting frame rises. Reunited in gunfire, what did Nepgear and I feel? Next episode, mobile game soldier Neptune and its name is Nepgeardom. Revive in the land of war, Nepgeardom.
That was extreme. Oh my goodness.
Hey, wow, that's our fault.
Hey, wake up, you fools.
Ugh, stop making so much noise in the morning, Soup Sock.
Who the hell is Soup Sock? I need food right now. I can't sit it. This mortal form has grown weak. I need sustenance.
Substance. Aw, man, too much trouble. Oh, these weeds look edible. Here you go, some healthy wild plants.
I heard you say weeds just now. Don't you mock me. Damn it, I can't escape when this book is absorbing my powers. On top of that, I'm so hungry I can't muster any strength. If I could at least eat something, I could probably gather enough power.
Since you started talking about food, now I'm getting hungry, Arbor. I wonder if we can have any breakfast.
Let's have some breakfast.
We can?
I gathered a bunch of edible-looking plants and vegetables while on the walk, and Uzumi's about to cook them for us.
Yippee! All right.
Here's my fish and vegetable roast. I made a lot, so have as much as you like. Oh my goodness, that was troubling for me. This looks great. I've always wanted to eat fish prepared this way. It's delicious. It's not all overcooked or rubbery either. You did great. I'm glad you like it so much. Here, I have more, so keep going.
Hey, Uzume, what are these shriveled purple-looking things on this skewer?
That's eggplant. Have you never eaten eggplant before? I just happened to find some fresh and tasty looking eggplants.
So this is an eggplant down the hatch. Wait for it.
Oh. How's it taste?
What is this food? It's beyond disgusting. In fact, I'd say it's borderline dangerous.
Really? I thought they tasted pretty good.
No. I'd rather eat Umeo before eating this freaky blackish purple garbage. Now, there's no need to eat me. Now, Nepsy, you're all grown up now, so you should eat all kinds of foods without being picky, you understand?
Oh my goodness.
The little Neptune has the same problem.
Yeah, I know.
What? But this doesn't taste good at all. The texture's all squishy and gross, too. Ugh, Umeo's like a nagging dad. This stuff isn't food for people at all, so what to do?
Then why don't I eat it for you?
This voice, Arbor, you'll really eat it for me?
Shh, don't talk so loud. See, no, I'm quite famished, and this is a fair deal, isn't it?
It's more than I could hope for if you'll eat it.
If you are being serious, then release me from this book so I may eat.
Nope. But in return, I'll feed them to you here.
I'm most grateful. Yes, what delicious eggplant. It's truly an eggplantish eggplant lunch.
There's another reference there.
Okay, we're calling it good now, though.
Okay.
It's It's like the same length as our normal ones.
Alright, well, it's going to be the end of this episode of Megadimension Neptunia. If you enjoyed, like, subscribe, and we'll see you all for the next episode. See ya!
Laters!